असली मुद्दा क्या है हमें स्पष्ट रूप से समझना चाहिए, जहां तक मेरी समझ है वो ये है कि इज द एग्जीक्यूटिव इंटरफियरिंग विद द फंक्शनिंग ऑफ द जुडिशरी। मेरे मन में एक ही सवाल है और कोई सवाल नहीं है, ये कौन जज करप्ट है कौन नहीं है इसमें मेरा कोई इंटरेस्ट नहीं है। आज एक करप्ट है, कल दूसरा होगा, उसके बाद तीसरा होगा, तो करप्शन होता रहता है, होता रहेगा, ये मामला नहीं है। लेकिन जो सरकार की इंटरफेरेंस है जुडिशरी से, उस मुद्दे पे हमें अपना ध्यान देना चाहिए। और तो यू द रियल प्लेयर्स इन दिस गेम आर बिहाइंड द पर्दा, ओके। इट इज़ नॉट द चीफ जस्टिस ऑफ इंडिया हु इज़ द मेन प्लेयर इन दिस गेम, नाइदर आर वी द मेन प्लेयर्स इन द गेम। द जुडिशरी कैन कोलैप्स फ्रॉम विद इन, बट द जुडिशरी कैन कोलैप्स फ्रॉम विद इन ओनली इफ there is a government willing to make it collapse from within. तो बहुत लोगों ने कहा है, किसी ने लिख भी दिया कि 1970-75 में मिसेज इंदिरा गांधी ने एक कोट एंड कोट कमिटेड जुडिशरी तैयार की या कोशिश की तैयार करने की, तैयार तो नहीं हुई लेकिन कोशिश की। उस समय आपको पता है कि काफ़ी जजेस ने रिज़ाइन किया, आज वो जजेस समझदार हो गए हैं, वो रिज़ाइन नहीं करेंगे। और हमारे तरफ से हमें ये डिमांड नहीं करनी चाहिए कि आप चार जजेस जो सामने आए हो मॉरल रीजंस के लिए रिज़ाइन करो, नहीं। द व्हाट हैपेंड इन 1975, यस हिस्टोरिकली दोज जजेस रिज़ाइंड एंड डिड अस अ फेवर, बट टुडे दीज फोर जजेस हैव डन अस अ बिगर फेवर बाय कमिंग आउट एंड एड्रेसिंग द प्रेस, by showing that there can be transparency in the judiciary, by showing that people like you and me have a right to know what's going on inside the judiciary. So I condemn those people who are condemning the judges for having come out. They have a vested interest. Now kuch do char shabd mein apne bahar ke bare mein bhi kehna chahungi. Main ye kahungi, maine itna to keh diya ki jab tak सरकार जुडिशरी को कोलैप्स नहीं करना चाहती है तब तक वो कोलैप्स नहीं होगी। यहाँ पे एक कोल्यूशन चल रहा है, लेकिन सवाल ये आता है हमारे सामने कि हु विल प्रोटेक्ट द इंडिपेंडेंस ऑफ द जुडिशरी। और मेरी समझ जो है वो है कि ओनली द लॉयर्स, ओनली द बार एसोसिएशंस हैव टू स्टैंड अप एंड रेज देयर वॉइस। They can protect the independence of the judiciary. It is not the government that can protect it, and they have certain limitations. They cannot protect themselves. But by coming out and addressing the press conference, they have ensured that they are protecting the independence of the judiciary. So, first and foremost, I would like all of you to support them and really clap for them. They deserve our full support. That's the first point that needs to be made. Now, we you see, Justice Kaushik Patil ne to keh hi diya ki iski jaanch to honi chahiye, lekin ye jab Justice Loya ka dehant hua usi samay Chief Justice ko suo moto inquiry karwani chahiye thi, kyun nahi hui? On whom is the burden of bringing this issue to the court? The burden of bringing the issue to the court is not on the family, let's be very clear about it. A crime is a crime against society if there is such a crime. Aaj hum ye nahi kehte ke he was murdered, I'm not saying that, lekin main iske bare mein bhi thoda itihas dena chahunga. Yes, I was representing the CBI in the investigation into the Sohrabuddin case. I was very much there and I have seen all the evidence. Unless I was convinced that there was a case, I would not have been able to argue in court with passion. And I can tell you that so long as I was there, not a single police officer got bail. Patil came to court on a stretcher, with accompanied by his astrologer, to the magistrate's court. There are photographs, you can see those photographs. I went to the magistrate's court in Ahmedabad and I appeared to oppose his bail, and bail was not given to him. He came in an ambulance, he went back in an ambulance. Vanzara's bail I opposed, Vanzara was not given bail. Matter came to the Supreme Court, I think it was somebody asking for bail in Ishrat Jahan's case. I mean, he did not get bail because I did my duty. And today I'm being told, oh, who are you? you are a stooge of the UPA. I reject that allegation. I did my duty and I am doing my duty today by coming here and standing and talking to you about this case. So back to the issue, jo aapne issue raise kiya hai, ye kya? Jaise maine kaha, jaise Italy mein mafia judges ko maar deti thi, wo hi samana yahan chal raha hai. So let's be clear, what's going on? If one judge can be killed, more than one can be killed. There's no doubt about it. आपने हिरेन पांडे के बारे में याद दिला दिया. आज तक हमें पता नहीं है उसको किसने मर्डर किया. तो आई हैड ओकेशन वंस टू टेल द सुप्रीम कोर्ट जज हियरिंग द बेल एप्लीकेशन, व्हाट आर यू ट्रस्टिंग द स्टेट फॉर? अ स्टेट विच कैनॉट प्रोटेक्ट इट्स ओन होम मिनिस्टर, आर दे गोइंग टू प्रोटेक्ट अस? Why will they protect us? If they can't protect their own home minister, who killed Arun Pandey? Tell me, give me an answer. They were speechless and that particular judge had to reject the bail application when I made that comment. But coming back to Justice Loya, as I said, first and foremost, it should have been, ought to have been a suo motu inquiry. Now, I don't want to address the question who should do the investigation. I can only say whether it's High Court or whether it's Supreme Court. I can only say it has to be a totally impartial, independent investigation. There's a big question mark in front of us. Who is independent? Who is going to conduct this inquiry? So right from the beginning when we've been demanding CBI inquiries, this question has been posed to me. Ms. Jaising, Vyapam scam. Vyapam scam, when we filed a petition, the demand was CBI inquiry. Us samay logon ne saaf mere se ye sawal poocha. Aap to keh rahi hai CBI inquiry chahiye, lekin aapko kya confidence hai ki CBI impartial hai? मैं सिर्फ इतना कहना चाहूँगी कि मुझे लगता है ये सही है या झूठ है मुझे पता नहीं, लेकिन सीबीआई के अंदर भी डिविजन्स हैं एंड वी शुड ट्राई एंड वाइडन दोज डिविजन्स विद इन द सीबीआई. आई डोंट थिंक वी कैन इवन सी द सीबीआई एज अ मोनोलिथ. देर आर पीपल विद इन द सीबीआई हु आर कीन टू डू देयर ड्यूटी, हु वॉन्ट टू डू देयर ड्यूटी. दे आर बींग प्रिवेंटेड फ्रॉम डूइंग देयर ड्यूटी एंड आर जॉब इज टू सीक आउट दोज पीपल and encourage them to do their duty. I know even in this very case, when I say this case, I'm not talking about Loya's case, I'm talking about the medical scam case. Even in that case, there were people who wanted. Don't forget an FIR has been lodged in the medical scam case. Let us not forget it. We are forgetting that. Okay? We are focusing all our attention on the Supreme Court, but there is today, till today, in spite of the fact that the PIL has been rejected, there is still an FIR sitting over there, lodged by the CBI. And a PE, preliminary investigation, is going on. One judge of the High Court was arrested. A couple of crores of rupees were found from his custody. Two other High Court judges are still under the CBI scanner. And who knows where this will end. Whether it will end at the doorstep of the Chief Justice, I'm not willing to say. Because I have not seen the evidence, I do not believe as a lawyer that I can talk without evidence. But I think that we can't afford to be short-sighted, nor can we afford to forget who is the main culprit and the main player in this game. And this is the reason why I went. People have criticized me. Why did you go for the press conference? Are, is there a kanoon in this country that only the press can go for a press conference? Isn't it open house? Isn't anyone welcome to walk into a press conference? I knew that this was a moment in history similar to the moment of the emergency. It was a moment in history similar to the moment when judges resigned. I could see no difference between judges resigning and judges coming and addressing the step. If anything, it was one step further. So I said to myself, I want to be part of this moment of history. I want to go and see for myself what's happening over there. Like an ordinary person, I went to see what's going on over there. Nothing more, nothing less. There was nothing sinister about it. Now it's being said, I went because I was part of the UPA. So I can only tell you that the evidence in the Sohrabuddin, and have you ever heard of a situation in which a witness to an abduction also gets murdered, Prajapati? He gets murdered. He gets murdered. Why? Because he's not then able to come and give evidence that he was witness, eyewitness to the abduction of Sohrabuddin, and Kausalbi was murdered. And we are all quiet. We are all sitting here, carrying on merrily, you know, as if nothing happened. And then we all know the history. You have already told us one judge was transferred against the others. Now, comes the question, why are we opposing this petition to be placed before Arun Mishra? Why? Okay, I want to read out to you. I had appeared in the Sanjeev Bhatt case. What the allegations are, all of you know what the allegations were over there. Now, it came out in the evidence that Mr. Gurumurthy, okay, he's an RSS leader, okay, he was drafting the affidavits of the state of Gujarat. And I took strong objection to this. This same Arun Mishra, I'm going to read out his judgment. This is what he says. Objection has been taken, etc., by Ms. Jaising that Gurumurthy has interfered with the administration of justice. Quote, this is from him. These are knowledgeable incumbents. What is an incumbent? An incumbent has to have an office. What office does Gurumurthy have in the administration of justice? We don't know. These are knowledgeable incumbents who can always be consulted and their opinions obtained. So, while the state is filing an affidavit saying that the accused should be prosecuted, they have a right to consult the RSS. In black and white, please read it. It's at page 44. And the same was shown to the said gentleman for his opinion. So the state of Gujarat drafts an affidavit and shows it to Gurumurthy for his opinion. He gives his opinion and his opinion is incorporated in the affidavit. And Justice Arun Mishra sees nothing wrong with this. Okay. Isliye maine kaha aapke Nagpur ki hawa yahan aa gayi. Same was shown to the state in his opinion. He would not support the course of justice in any manner. When certain pleading is to be filed in court, there is, read this, listen to this carefully. When a pleading has to be filed in court, there is no legal bar on consulting with appropriate persons of confidence of having requisite knowledge. I rest my case. If Justice Arun Mishra thinks that Gurumurthy is quote unquote an appropriate person who should be consulted in the matter of taking decisions what to file and not to be filed in court, how can we have confidence in him that he will hear this case in an impartial manner? So there are good reasons. I agree, one should not ask for the recusal of a judge without reason. I fully agree. I agree that we, you, me, we have no right to choose our judge. But we do have a right to demand that the administration of justice is not polluted from external sources. So today, people say, I think it was Tavleen Singh, she put out a tweet today. And she said, oh, Mrs. Gandhi wanted a loyal judiciary. And we don't want to go down that road. So what is the answer to that? The answer to that is, madam, your government also wants a loyal judiciary. That's why we are seeing what we are seeing in the country today. This is what it's all about. I would just like to end by saying, at the end of the day, all governments want a quote unquote loyal judiciary. And we are the only ones who can prevent this this from happening. Thank you.